today we are going to Knox College, right, Samantha? Yeah, we are on the way there. It's going to take me, well, we left about 6 o'clock, somewhere around there. And it's going to take about another 2 hours and 10 minutes right now. So we're heading to Knoxville. Knox College. Samantha, we're going to check it out. Samantha got a, what do you call that? What did you get? Scholarship. Go to Knox. So, we'll see. We'll see you there.
Alright, so if you're traveling outside Chicago, this is what you see. It's nothing but flats. We're known for, Illinois is known for, are called as Flatlanders. Up in Wisconsin, you know, Flatlanders, that's how flat. A little bit of hill there, but not really. No big hills, no mountains, just flat cornfield. As far as like Midwest, like Indiana, Iowa, Ohio. That's what it looks like. It's nothing but cornfield. Well, right now it's December, so those are frozen. Frozen ground, so you can see. Grass looks dead, but they're pretty much alive in winter. And they've turned green in the summertime. So that's what it looks like.
Samantha over there. Just gotta go bathroom. I'm gonna go check out some of those pictures. Oh, this cool picture right here. This is like a sliding picture. It changes colors. TV screen. Like that. Huh. Kind of gives me an idea at home. Oh, look at that Knox College. First colored ever play for Knox baseball. I don't know that, but I was just guessing. Abe Lincoln. Look at that, Abe Lincoln. There was Don talking to an employee who works here probably. But this is the alumni building. Yeah, we gotta wear a mask, they said. They even took our temperature.
Alright,
so we're going for a tour now. This guy right there, I forgot his name, but he's gonna give us a tour. A tour of the Knox College. No, this is not Hard Knox. It's K-N-O-X, Knox College. So, we'll see you there. Well,
graduation
insane. Looks like we're going inside again, so.
But the students didn't really take any classes on campus until 1857 because there were no buildings. So in 1857, this is when Old Bay was built. It's the oldest building on campus, and so the first floor is kind of like a little museum dedicated to the history of Knox and Galesburg. And then the second and third floor have classrooms that house like history, philosophy, creative writing. It kind of smells like history in here, I think. I don't know if that makes sense, but I think it does.
No.
Yeah.
It's the map of Illinois.
We'd like to stop here to point out our lovely alumni, Israel Catani. He was a Knox International Student from Iraq, and he is significant because he founded the Knox Honor Code. So every college or university has their own form of an honor code. But at Knox, it's a little unique because it was founded by a Knox student, and it's completely run by Knox students themselves. So we have an honor board that's comprised of one representative from each academic year. So the honor board, they make sure that students are holding themselves accountable. Also, the whole student body does that too. So we are very academically honest here. Also, just being a small community that
progresses.
Like, sense of honesty and everything like that is already kind of there since we're so small, but the honor code kind of just another aspect to that. So one of the coolest parts of the honor code, I think, is that the majority of our exams are non-proctored. So in completing the classroom, I just feel like my boss is having their spaces to row. Yeah, and just
a whole Bible right here. Yeah,
definitely. Oh, yeah, of COVID protocols, we've closed all of our water fountains. I feel like the station still works for the water fountains, but sometimes I forget. So like Reggie said, so Knox was the site of the fifth blinking down to the day. That was one of the more significant ones because this is where it's like a
deal. Yeah.
At a
So right on the steps, Lincoln denounced slavery.
Sorry.
Yeah, no worries. That's super fun. I wish my mom did that.
Stephen A. Douglas. Right on the stairs right here. 100 years ago.
Yeah.
That's right. Right over there. And then right inside that door, and right inside a room with the Lincoln chair. Where he sat, so it was locked, so we couldn't get in there. But so this is George Davis. Room. GGH, GDH, George Davis. I thought he said Davis, but anyway, Davis. So every room you'll see, there's only like limit occupancy. 15, I think, is due to COVID. Oh, there's people over there. People, like, I think, class in session. No. There's people testing.
It was around 8. That was an upper level biology class that I took. One of my friends, he was an Africana study.
Clerk hole.
Okay, how about
not across the street now. That's a county jail?
There were some on campus protests. No, not on campus. There were some protests around Galesburg. Lots of Knox students were located in there. Yeah, I would say Knox is definitely more of like a liberal left leading institution, or like the majority of students.
High school, like middle school, that's why I'm asking, like,
but differences in like human rights. Like,
it was a bit weird. I remember driving into Knox, my first ever visit.
Like, don't walk at night alone at like 2 a.m. Like,
right.
In a like in a part of town that you don't know.
In general, I said in a polar vortex.
Oh my god, yeah. You'd literally die.
Yeah. You, yeah, it's just like basic common sense, you know.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, so that building right there, that's campus safety. It's kind of in their name. They just drive around and make sure that everything is in order.
Okay.
Sick bike.
I was very generous donor to Modern Visual Arts Center. It's become
I can't even see it.
Popular buildings on campus for our students. Like, it's literally a haven for them. It's so nice. We have pretty much everything, so printmaking, sculptures, upstairs.
What in the world is this?
Senior studio art majors will get their own space for a whole term, or sometimes for a whole year. And it's kind of just their own creative space to do pretty much anything they want for their senior portfolio. So the majority of majors at Knox, like, part of your major requirement is some sort of senior. Yeah. Are you mostly looking at ones like around the corner? Yeah. For me, it was really nice to be close to home. Or close-ish to home like that. Close enough that I don't have to drive every day.
It's the best stuff on campus.
Big trees.
I really love Knox. I'm really grateful for what it's given me. Helping you to
that we will be doing. That's the Center for Fine Arts. That's our performing arts. And then
behind that is our gym, our fitness center. So we have a gym, a swimming pool, basketball court, volleyball court, field house, everything. Yeah, it's great for faculty.
This is kind of the money shot that we'll do. This is where we have commencement every year, except for this past spring.
I better have an in-person commencement. Lined up full of students like advertising their clubs and different events that are happening. Usually these walls are packed with their head right there.
Yeah.
I'm proud of myself. I can read that.
I don't need to take school meeting.
Yeah.
Love that.
First job. Yeah. Tour guide job. He's done so much for the club.
Nice.
So you just would get invited and they'd give you food. I'm sorry, like, we didn't know people really liked it, so we're pretty bad. Also, they're very accommodating with dietary restrictions. We have like a fully vegan and vegetarian area.
BLM. That's my steps here. Yo.
Term at Knox, you'll take first year presentorial class that will teach you like college level reading, writing, and discussion. There will be like so many different subjects. They're usually kind of like weird or quirky and fun. One of them was, my friend took, was called Walking as a Way of Knowing, and their whole thing was to go on walks.
plus 80, plus a rack, plus dollar.
That is like so 20 years ago.
Selection process and housing process, you'll fill out those forms the summer prior to arriving, and they won't put you anywhere where you don't want to be. So we have like single sex or co-ed dorms. So if you like, you mark whichever one you want, whichever you don't want, they won't put you in the one you don't want, which is really nice. So this building, this is actually Knox's baby. We renovated this part of the building within the past year. So this is the Science and Math Center, or SMAC. That's what the students call it. So we have
it's like a fraternity house. Well, looks like there's a homeless guy over there wheeling his stuff around. How convenient. How convenient. Dark in here.
For your classes or different learning research. The new administration just canceled.
dark in here.
So definitely like renting or just like checking out books for free.
Yeah.
It's definitely the way to go.
Get that air in there again. Air protection.
It's another old building that has the old smell, like the old energy to it. It has an old library.
I feel like some old spirit in here. It's haunted. This library is haunted, I can tell you that. All those books on the floor. Got that medieval architecture, King's Portal, Christian Rome, early Christian Rome, catacombs and basilicas, by Filippi Fregola, guide the Pagan Agora, Egyptian architecture. Architecture as cultural expression, poems and essays, and the ruins of the most beautiful monuments of Greece. But I believe this library is haunted, and I can sense bad spirit, or maybe I just have to take a dump, I don't know which one.
To the top, they didn't want students going up there.
Okay.
Just for COVID
yeah.
precautions.
It smells like